What's happening, FTD fam? Welcome back to FTD Speaks. So, of course, we're going to continue the gin series. We're getting down to the last few episodes, so let's just jump into this one.
The fact that Adam alayhi salam made dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala immediately when he realized that he made a mistake. Adam immediately made dua when he ate from the tree and his nakedness became apparent to him and he began to cover himself with the leaves of the tree. Immediately he realized he made a mistake, instantaneously, and he made a dua right then and there. What did he say? رَبَّنَا ظَلَمْنَا أَنفُسَنَا وَإِن لَمْ تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Oh my Lord, I have wronged. We have wronged ourselves. And if you don't forgive us and you don't have mercy on us, then of a surety, we will be of those who are lost. So of the signs of a mu'min, of the signs of a true follower of Adam, not just a descendant of Adam, but a follower of Adam. All of us are descendants of Adam. But some of us choose to follow the methodology of the Prophet Adam. Of the sign of the prophetic methodology, you make dua immediately when there is a need. You don't delay it. When you commit a sin, when you need anything, worldly or religious or spiritual, you make the dua right then and there. Contrast this to Iblis. Iblis, Allah tells him to prostrate. He says, no, I'm not going to prostrate. I am better than him. This is jahiliyyah. This is racism. I'm better than him because I have a better creation material than you do. My skin color is better. My ethnicity is better. My language is better. We still have the same satanic racism present amongst Muslims to this day. The same satanic racism. I am better than so-and-so because of where I'm from, because of the color of my skin, etc., etc. So Iblis says, I am better than him. I'm not going to prostrate. So Allah curses him until the day of judgment. Allah tells him to leave. And Iblis in his arrogance refuses till the very last second, until he realizes he has no other alternative and he sees this curse and he realizes he shall forever be cursed. So then Iblis is forced to make a dua. Unlike Adam, Adam makes the dua coming from him. Adam makes the dua instantaneously. Iblis, he only makes dua when all other opportunities are closed, when everything else is shut off. And he sees now there's nothing else for me, well, let me try making dua. And so Iblis also makes a dua. What is the dua that Iblis makes? قَالَ أَنظِرْنِي إِلَى يَوْمِ يُبْعَثُونَ. Iblis says, Oh Allah, allow me to live until the day of judgment. Let me live until the day of judgment. And so right from the get-go, we learn a fundamental difference between Adam and Iblis. Adam alayhi salam has a continual link with Allah. He's always making dua. Iblis, this was the only time he ever made dua. He never made dua after this. The only time, because he's gotten his need. Adam alayhi salam, when he came down to this earth, we know he was a prophet, a righteous man. He continued to worship, he continued to pray, he continued to make dua. So the sign of a believer is constant dua. When you ask man for more and more, he becomes angry at you. But when you ask Allah for more and more, he loves you. I repeat, the more you ask of your fellow man, the more irritated he becomes at you. You don't ask your friends too much because then they won't be your friends too long. But ask for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more you ask Allah, the more Allah loves you. Why? Because the relationship between Allah and His servant is one of servitude. Is that not correct? What is our relationship between ourselves and Allah? It is one of servitude. What does the servant need? Everything from the master. What does a servant require? What doesn't he require? He requires everything. Not just his clothes, his food, the air that we breathe, Allah gives it to us. The life that we have, Allah gives it to us. How can the servant feel arrogant against Allah? How can the servant say, I can't ask Allah this? Who else are you going to ask? Where else are you going to get it from? A sign of iman is to recognize that everything that you need will only come from Allah. And once you recognize that, who else are you going to ask other than Allah? And therefore, making dua is a characteristic of faith, is a characteristic of iman. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ أُدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. Your Lord has commanded you, said to you, make dua to me, I will respond to you. This is a command from Allah. Make dua, I will respond to you. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, verily, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry at the person who does not ask him. Allah is angry at such a person because he's showing arrogance. He's showing a sense of superiority. And how can, a'udhu billah, any created being show an iota of pride, show an atom's weight of superiority against the divine? How is this even possible? So the mu'min is ever making dua. The mu'min is making dua for each and every need of his. The mu'min is always engaged. Dua is a conversation with Allah. Dua is our conversation with Allah. And therefore, the one whose iman is high is forever having a conversation.
Okay, so I'm understanding a bit more the differences between prayer and dua according to Islam. You know, prayer is like that set time that Muslims pray 5 times a day. It's also known as salat. And dua is having a conversation with God, like asking God for guidance or for forgiveness and things like that. That's the dua. So I'm just kind of seeing more and more of the distinction there. And this one, it's pretty interesting just hearing the account of a supernatural being, Iblis, being arrogant and saying, no, I'm better than somebody else. And at the same time, when he doesn't get his way or sees that there's no other option, he then goes back to God and asks God for a favor. It's kind of like asking your dad, like you steal your dad's money, you know, you break down your dad's furniture and everything and poke holes in his car, his possession, you know, insult your dad for doing what he did. And then, oh, by the way, dad, can I have $1,000? It's like it's disrespectful, you know. So that's pretty interesting to see that account there. And you know, this was just a big reminder to Muslims that dua, having that conversation with God, asking God for forgiveness, being in constant conversation, is a sign that you have faith, and also it's a command. And also, don't wait too long. If you mess up, right away, go as quickly as you can. Don't be waiting last minute and then saying, oh, but by the way, you know, I see the parallel there. You know, I see how this could be something that's like really, really, really disrespectful, especially when you go and then apply it to on a human level. This is supernatural between a person and God. But, you know, when you apply that to a human level, we can really see how insulting that kind of behavior could be. That's all I want to say for this one, guys. Thanks for hanging out with me in another episode looking at the Jinn series. Again, we're coming down to the end, pretty close to the end, guys. It's been an amazing series. So stick around every single Monday for new episodes, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Later.